Hello and welcome in this session on transfer of learning. Sometimes it is also known as transfer of training. You must have observed that if someone is riding on bicycle and if he or she wants to learn how to ride on a bike, so the person who ride on bicycle learn riding on motorbike easily in comparison to a person who is not riding on bicycle. Similarly, you recall the old days when there were typewriters and many people were very comfortable in typing on typewriters. And when computer keyboards came into the existence, the people who were using typewriter earlier, they felt easy to work on computer keyboard as compared to the person who have never used typewriter. So what can you conclude from these two examples? Let us think, what is transfer of learning? Actually, learning in one context and applying it to another context, that is the capacity to apply the acquired knowledge and the skills to new situations, is basically known as transfer of learning. So if you learn something in one situation and your capacity to apply that learning into another situation is basically your ability to transfer your learning. Similarly, some people are of the opinion that acquisition of skills, habits, knowledge, and attitude, when it influences the acquisition of new learning, then it is also known as transfer of learning. Transfer of learning depends upon many factors. One such factor is the resemblance and similarity between the situation, means the earlier learning situation and the new learning situation. More resemblance, more similarity means more learning. So some people call it that it is nothing but generalization of the skills which one acquires in one situation and apply in another situation. Some people also believe that presence of identical elements, methods, or goal in two or more different situations basically facilitates transfer of learning. So if there are more identical elements, more methods, then more transfer of learning. When we talk about transfer of learning, there are many definitions of transfer of learning. One such definition is that transfer of learning is ability of finding out the identity of relationship or using it to a new situation. Like you learn something in one situation and when new situation comes, you try to find out the identity of relationship between the two situations and you use it. When we talk about types of transfer of learning, there are different ways to classify it or to tell that how many types of transfer of learning is there. But one such type is that there is positive transfer of learning, there is negative transfer of learning, and there is zero transfer of learning. Let us see what these are. Positive transfer of learning. Positive transfer of learning means that if the learning in one situation facilitates the learning in another situation. For example, if someone is playing violin and he or she wants to play piano, so the knowledge of keys and the sound, musical sounds associated with the keys, is get transferred from one situation to another situation and they feel easy to play piano. Similarly, if someone knows mathematics, learning physics becomes easy. I have already given you one example that if someone is driving a bicycle, it facilitates driving on a motorbike. So these are known as positive transfer of learning. Another is negative transfer of learning. If learning of one skill in one situation makes the learning of another skill or another situation difficult. For example, if someone has learned one particular language and if he or she wants to learn another language which has no resemblance with the previous language, then it is difficult to learn that language. Similarly, if there is any old habit and that habit is hindering to learn or develop new habit, then it is known as negative transfer of learning. Like you put dates and year every day, and in the month of the December, suppose you are writing 20th December 2019, after 10 days January came and it is 2020, but often initially in January you keep writing 2019, 2019, 2019. That is your habit which has been developed in 1 year and it is hindering to learn or develop new habit. Then zero transfer of learning, or you can say neutral transfer of learning or no transfer of learning. So if there is no resemblance between two situations, then learning of one activity neither facilitates nor hinders the learning of another activity or a skill. For example, knowing a particular language doesn't affect or impact to learn driving. According to Simmons in 1999, there are three types of transfer of learning. First is prior knowledge to learning. Means the learner uses his or her prior knowledge to learn anything new. Then second is learning to new learning. If a learner has acquired something, has learned something, and when he or she wants to learn something new, then the previous learning facilitates or hinders new learning. Then third is learning to application. Means if someone has learned some theory, some principles, some basic concepts, and if he or she is able to apply those concepts, those theories in practical situation of life, then that is called learning to application. There are four very common forms of transfer of learning. First is lateral, another is vertical, third one is sequential, and fourth one is bilateral. Let us discuss in brief that what are these forms. Lateral transfer of learning means the transfer of learning or transfer of knowledge or skill from a situation to another situation of similar level. Let me take an example from mathematics, that if in class you have taught to your students that 5 minus 2 equal to 3, and if a learner went back to home and at home there are 5 bananas and mother asked him or her to eat 2 bananas, and then mother asked how many bananas are there in fridge or in fruit basket. So if learner is able to apply the knowledge of the same level, and if he or she is able to answer there are 3 bananas left in fridge or basket, it means the lateral transfer of learning takes place. Vertical transfer of learning means learning from one situation to acquire any higher order skill, or transfer of learned skill from one situation to a higher situation. Let us take again one example from mathematics. Suppose in class, as a teacher, you have taught to your students that any number if multiplied by 0, the answer will be 0. And you have given example like 2 multiplied by 0, 21 multiplied by 0, 33 multiplied by 0. And suddenly you have given him or her a question where there are 3 scores like 255, 132, 72, all are multiplied, and again there is a multiply by 0. So if a student is able to answer quickly that its answer will be 0, then it means he or she has transferred the skill of the lower level to higher level. But if a student starts first multiplying 255 into 132, then the answer will be multiplied by 72, then the answer will be multiplied by 0, it means he or she has not transferred the learning to a higher order skill. Then sequential transfer of learning. Sequential transfer of learning means when learning something is essential to learn another thing. So learning takes place in a sequence. Like if a student wants to learn division or multiplication, then if he or she has not learned addition or subtraction, he or she will not be able to learn division. So learning addition and learning subtraction is condition for multiplication. Similarly, learning addition, subtraction and multiplication is condition for learning division. So such type of transfer is known as sequential transfer of learning. And this transfer takes place generally at same level. Another very interesting transfer of learning is bilateral transfer of learning. This is also known as self-transfer of learning. So if someone has learned something from the right part of the body and it is being transferred to left part of the body, like you have learned how to draw a figure from the right hand, or you have learned how to write from the right hand, and suddenly when you required, your left hand also starts working the same task. This is called bilateral transfer of learning. It takes place up to a certain extent in everyone, but among few it is so perfect that you can see a person can draw the same picture from both hands simultaneously. Or there is a very good experiment of mirror drawing apparatus. They can draw a figure which they have drawn with right hand by watching its image in a mirror, and they can practice the same with the left hand. So this is called bilateral transfer of learning. There are certain theories of transfer of learning also, which are basically facilitating to develop our understanding how transfer of learning takes place. And the oldest one is the mental faculty theory. In earlier days, it was assumed that mind is composed of a number of independent faculties like memory, attention, will, imagination, reasoning, temperament, etc. And any particular faculty can work in every situation. For example, memory. If someone has memorized something, then he or she can memorize another thing also. So if a person possesses strong memory, he or she can use it in any situation, and he or she will be able to remember anything. But this theory was abandoned later on. Then another theory replaced it is known as theory of formal disciplines. This theory basically believes that there are certain subjects or instructional items which have their disciplinary value apart from the knowledge value. The subjects like classics, Latin, Sanskrit, geometry, logic, grammar. And the proponent of the formal discipline theory believes that the students who study these subjects, their mind get trained and their faculties of observation and scientific thinking get strengthened. So when they study these subjects, they can learn anything in all situations of life because their minds get trained. Geometry, for instance, it is believed that it is enough to strengthen the reasoning faculty of the mind. But this theory is also not in practice nowadays. Another very important theory is theory of identical elements. This theory basically believes that the previous learning facilitates new learning only to the extent that the new learning task contains elements identical to those in the previous tasks. And this theory was proposed by Thandai. So the crux of the theory is that the presence of identical elements between the previous learning and the new learning decides the level of transfer of learning. So transfer of learning from one situation to other is roughly proportional to the degree of resemblance in both the situations. So you can say that more the similarity, more will be the transfer. Next very important theory was given by Charles Judd, known as theory of generalization of experiences. This theory believes that when someone learns any new task or activity, they develop certain general principles. And when they move to next or new learning situation, they apply those general principles either in part or in whole. So this theory basically talks about the activity or the principles involved in the process of learning which can be used to learn new situations. So you can say that it is an act of perceiving general things in various situations. Experiences, habits, knowledge, which we gain in one situation, it helps us to the extent to which we can generalize or apply it to any other situation. Next theory is transposition theory. This theory is also known as theory of gestalt psychologists, and you all know that gestalt psychologists believe in whole part relation. So this theory suggests that transfer of learning is dependent upon the whole part relations between the old and new situation. So it is the understanding of the relationship between the facts, processes, and principles which decides transfer. And this is also known as transposition theory, because there is a need for transposition from older situation to the new situation. Let us talk in brief about the classroom implications of transfer of learning. If we want to use transfer of learning to facilitate learning, you should focus on the content which is not only useful in your subject but also in other subjects. As a teacher, we should understand the importance of previous knowledge, because previous knowledge also get transferred and facilitate the new learning. And we should also explain the benefits of acquiring new skills. In our classroom, we should stress on significant interrelationships of different subjects, how science and mathematics are related, how social sciences are related to each other, what is the relationship between language and science, language and social science. All such relationships should be stressed. Also, we should try to transfer the learning within the classroom and outside of the classroom. That is called application of knowledge gained in the classroom into practical situation out of the classroom. And if we use transfer of learning effectively, we will be able to develop the problem-solving abilities among our learners. So with this, I must say that by using transfer of learning, we can facilitate learning. So let's facilitate transfer of learning in our students.